We all think of time as having a direction. Yesterday was the past, tomorrow is the future. But what if I told you that none of the equations that govern our universe have anything to do with the direction of time? Newton's laws, gravity, even quantum laws like Schrödinger's equation work just as well going backwards as forwards. Physics says that if you break an egg, in theory, you should be able to unbreak it and you'd have no mess to clean up. I know this sounds ridiculous, but what about a simpler system like the Earth going around the Sun? If you didn't already know the direction of Earth's orbit, it would be pretty difficult to tell whether it was going forward or backward. The physical laws of motion, velocity, acceleration, even gravity are totally unchanged. So how are we so sure that this movie of the egg unscrambling itself is being played backwards? Time's direction is given purely by the second law of thermodynamics. It says that the entropy of the universe is always increasing. Entropy is the measure of randomness, disorder, or messiness of a system. A low entropy system would be very ordered and organized. A high entropy system would be kind of a mess. And the second law of thermodynamics is saying that the universe is always becoming messier. Here's an example. Hot tea and cold milk will mix together into a warm tea milk, but they'll never unmix again into cold milk and hot tea. As the tea and milk particles swirl and jostle around together, the system is becoming more disordered and entropy is increasing, and it will never decrease. If you were shown a picture of half-mixed milk tea, you would be able to predict where it's headed. The only difference between now and then is that entropy has increased. This is kind of where our universe is now. One day, in the far distant future, it'll reach a point of maximum entropy, where it just can't get any more jumbled up. At this point, there would be no difference between past, present, and future, and time as we know it would cease to exist. Believe it or not, this one aspect of our universe is what gives time its direction. In the past, there was lower entropy than there is now, and in the future, there will be higher entropy. So I know what you're thinking. What about that one time you cleaned your room, right? It went from a messy, disordered state to a neat, ordered state. Doesn't that break the second law of thermodynamics? Well, even though the entropy of your room has decreased, the entropy of the entire universe has increased. When you move around your room and you pick up things and you place them here and there, you start to get hot, and the heat from your body rises into the air and makes the atoms and molecules all vibrate. So even though it looks like the entropy of your room has decreased, the atoms and molecules on the microscopic scale have gone into a bit of a frenzy. The entropy of the entire universe has increased, and the second law is safe and sound. So why is entropy always increasing? Is it just some random law of our universe? Well, it turns out that disorder is just more likely than order. Imagine you have six dice, each with six different possibilities. A very ordered or low entropy state would be if all dice rolled a six, but the chances of this happening are so fantastically small. You'd have to roll the dice 46,656 times to get that combination. But for high entropy, disordered states, there's a much higher probability of being rolled simply because there's so many more of them. Now imagine that every single atom in the universe is a die, except instead of having six possible states, it has millions, billions, trillions of possible states. Even for a simple system like the tea and milk, there are so many more possible ways that the particles can be messily mixed together than neatly separated. It's not impossible, but the chances are so tiny you'd have to wait a lot longer than the lifetime of the universe. So if you ever feel like you're in this constant battle against the universe to keep your room clean or to keep your life organized, you're right. The real question is, why was entropy ever low in the first place? I mean, if order and neatness are so improbable, isn't it a bit odd that the universe just happened to begin that way? This question has been one of the biggest unsolved mysteries in physics for over 50 years, but some recent discoveries hint at an explanation. Physicists used to think that the universe had kind of always existed the way it is. But then astronomers realized that all of the galaxies are flying apart. So if the universe is expanding, this means that once upon a time, everything was really close together. This tiny, hot, dense speck of matter exploded into everything that exists now. But that still doesn't explain why the universe ever started in a low entropy state to begin with. I mean, a huge, hot explosion sounds pretty messy. One hypothesis is that we live in a multiverse where new baby universes are popping into existence all the time. Our universe is just one of many, and these baby universes could somehow start with low entropy while the entropy of the multiverse increases as a whole. Kind of like when you clean your room. Part of the universe becomes tidy while the chaoticness of the rest of it goes up. This is just one theory, and there needs to be a lot more evidence before it can even begin to look promising. To describe the early state of the universe, we need to combine quantum mechanics and general relativity. two things which, at the moment, just don't seem to go together. If physicists could somehow fuse these into an ultimate theory of everything, all questions would be answered, we'd be able to understand the mysteries of our universe and explain the arrow of time. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe. Just click on my face if you want to see more videos like this one. If you guys want to see more videos about time and entropy and the universe, please let me know in the comments below and I would be happy to do that for you. And yeah, make sure to check back soon. Bye!